What's up, guys? This is Trainman Dan, and we're going to be exploring my world that I'm currently in progress with. But now I'm trying to get set up. So this is pretty much most of it right now. So we go to one of my sessions. For the trip, we'll be using a Paramarquette 1220, and we'll hopefully get some good footage. And then, yeah. If you're wondering why you hear a creak sound in the background, it's like a chair. So just to let you know. Yeah. I use this once in a while, the chat thing, but I mostly play single player, so it's no point of doing it right now. I mean, to be honest, I like Trainz 2012 better than New Era because there's reasons why. One, almost every single sound I've heard in Trainz New Era has like the same, what you call it, sounds. As the, as 12, 2006, and Trainz 2004, I believe. But anyway, so, this, and we'll get ready for the trip. For some reason, the bell doesn't work on this trip, so let's go. Only the 765 one works. And I know this lags a little bit. And I can for some reason, I don't know why. Maybe it's whole trip will probably be like a good 25 minutes possibly, so I don't know what the footage will look like later, but this out until the exciting part happens. And as you can see, I have a city built, and I'll show you that later in a second part that I'll make for the lower level of the world or something like that. And the GG1s, and they actually updated their new sounds. So I quite like the GG1 sounds now. I'll probably show you that in another one. Rolling right now. I kind of like the sounds on the cars for what you call it. Cars, what you call it? This doesn't have any sound for some reason, or it was just built like that. I do like this engine, but I like the 765 whistle probably the best. So, as you can see, you heard the cars. Yeah. I mean, this isn't really the start of the road, but like once we get down to like near like where you see the bottom part of the railroad, then that's where it like really started for the top level of this. But yeah, this is where pretty much the longest bridge I had, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that one, I think probably about the same for this, but I could be wrong. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, it's about the same. It's 8 for each one. So far we haven't lagged, which is good. Slow down a little bit. But let's look in the cab. Turn it down a little bit. So we pretty much have this almost standard inside of the locomotive. We've got a firebox, throttle, reverser. That's the city right there. There's an Amtrak that's passing by now. Surprisingly going well. But yeah, again, this is Trainz 2012. I do really recommend you get this game over Trainz: A New Era, but other than that, this is a great game. Probably better than all the other ones. Yeah. This is probably the biggest route I ever made from all my other ones. There's a 2006 one I have that I don't use that much. I use it really once in a while. I'm kind of crossing, so might as well blow the whistle, I guess. Yeah. It does some great detail on this. I would pick 1225, but it's on the bottom level. Next one, I'll see what you guys think I should do. I'll name it later. Notice the bell when I like push it. It like sways back and forth, which is really cool. And the 1725 too. The only two engines you can play in the Air Marquette are the only two I think that have that feature. far, we're doing good. Not much lag. My mic isn't that good, but once I get a multiple USB port or a multiple USB hub, then I'll be able to use my other mic a lot better. I do like the sound of the cars when they are rolling, I guess. But yeah, let's go back to the back of my train, I guess. We got some Pensy cars, some more Pensy, we got Illinois Central, Baby Ruth, there's also another thing though, like about Trainz New Era. I mean, you can check it out, trailer, and a link above. And the one, there's another reason I don't like it because I think it has a requires multiple windows, I think. I'm not really fully sure, but that's what I heard. It's like, nobody wants like windows popping out of nowhere and just causing a lot of lag. But yeah, if you're a model driver, you might like this. It's worth getting, but I'm not saying you have to. You know I should do. Let's go to a railroad crossing real quick. Let's capture some of these footage. Okay. Alright. So as you can see, the car is pretty cool. We got another train here, which we might do for this part, or either the Y6B, which is running on the track on the left. Yeah. This is that car. I just realized there's two exact same cars that just went across, so you know. So, yeah. Yeah. But anyway, let's blow the whistle, I guess. I don't know why, but I love this whistle for some reason. There's the Y6B over there. I'll just hold it on there, put some like cameras where you go to a line of sight view where it just basically captures it and you go to that mode. Yeah. I mean, I picked this locomotive because I mean, most of the people out there that like steam, I prefer this too. I moved in the Y6B too. So I just realized we have kind of a side-by-side view too. So that's neat. Yeah. So, the original part of where I started the railroad, I guess. I put a few buildings here. What else? This was just added recently. This has been here for a while. The oldest part is probably where the bridges are over there. And that part of the city too. But it's still a work in progress right now. Just note that. The part where there's three tracks and like three whole bridges that you have to cross on this one. I think two for that one. It goes to a little town there. No, that's the mine. Down there is a little town. There's a switch that goes back to the one town we just started at too. So yeah. Yeah. But I'll cut this part out because it's a little too long. But yeah, I'm thinking about the Y6B, which is right over there. This one too. I kinda like this one. I had a few trees too. There's some more cars here too. Too close to it.